हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द थर्ड यूनिट दैट इज जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म इन द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस। ओके, वी नो दैट इन द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन वी हैव अ लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म एल ऑफ एफ ऑफ टी, right? It is also denoted by something f of s, and this was integral from 0 to infinity e to the power minus st f of t dt. So if we apply, if we multiply e to the power minus st to f of t and then take its integral from 0 to infinity with respect to t, such a operator is called, or such a transformation is called, Laplace transformation of a function. And we use this Laplace transformation to solve the differential equations. At many more events, we have used this Laplace transformation. The parallel concept with this Laplace transformation in differential equation is here in difference equation, and we call it as Z transform. In place of Laplace transform, what we are calling it as Z transform. Okay, it is Z transform. So let us begin with definition of Z transform. The Z transform of a sequence yn, if we have any sequence yn, that means yn means what? This is your y1, y2, y3, y4, and so on. That means what? You can also write it as y of t, y of t plus 1, y of t plus 2, and so on. Such types of terms are there. Okay. The Z transform of a sequence yn is a function of Z, which is denoted by capital Y, of a complex variable defined by y of Z, that is Z transform of yk, is equal to summation from 0 to infinity yk upon z raised to k. So if we want to find the z transform of yk, then what we are doing? We are multiplying it by z to the power minus k. Multiplying yk by z to the power minus a and taking summation from k equal to 0 to infinity. What was in Laplace transform? While taking Laplace transform of any function, you are multiplying by e to the power minus st. In place of e to the power minus st, you have taken z to the power minus k. And integral from 0 to infinity, in place of integral, we are taking summation from 0 to infinity. That is the only difference. So this may be the kernel here in Z transform, because this was the kernel in Laplace transform. E to the power minus st was called kernel of Laplace transform. So this is the kernel there. Okay. And here summation from k equal to 0 to infinity. Here summation is from t equal to, here it is an integral from t equal to 0 to infinity. Okay. That is the only change. Okay. Now that is e to the power minus s. E to the power s is replaced by here z only. That is the only case. So the Z transform of any sequence yn is given by capital Y of Z is Z of yk, which is equal to summation from k equal to 0 to infinity yk upon z raised to k, or yk into z to the power minus k. So this is a simple definition of Z transform of yk, Z transform of any sequence yk. Okay. Now, and we say that Z transform exists provided, when we say that Z transform of any function exists, provided there is a number capital R greater than 0 such that this summation converges. Converges means what? It is something less than some capital K for mod Z greater than R. So for all values of Z, whatever Z we have taken large, this summation should converge to some number. It should not be infinity. It should not be infinity. This summation has to be some value as mod z is greater than r. Mod z is greater than r. So there is a number r which is positive, and for all mod z greater than r, right, this summation, if this summation converges to some number, then we say that this z transform of yk exists. That means summation exists, and summation exists means what? Z transform. So when we say that z transform exists, if this exists, when we say that this exists for any value of z where mod z is greater than r, this should be converges to some number. Okay, the sequence yk is said to be exponentially bounded if there is a m greater than 0 and a c greater than 1 such that mod of yk less than or equal to m times c to the power k for k greater than or equal to 0. Now when we say that any sequence is simply bounded, we know that sequence SN is bounded. When we say that it is bounded, if mod of SN less than or equal to some m for n greater than or equal to capital N. There exists some n, that means for all large values of n, this modulus should be less than or equal to m. In place of only bounded, what we are doing? Exponentially bounded. That means if this modulus is less than or equal to m times m as it is, c to the power k. Exponential means here we obtain exponential of c, that is power of c. What is it? K. That's why as exponent term is there, therefore we are calling it as exponentially bounded. Okay, but there are conditions. There m is positive, c should be greater than 1, isn't it? And k is non-negative number. K is non-negative number. So if there exist positive m, c greater than 1, satisfying this condition for all k greater than or equal to 0, then we say that sequence yk is exponentially bounded. Now we will solve, or we will see first result on this z transform and exponentially bounded. If the sequence yk is exponentially bounded, then z transform of yk exists. So we get a sufficient condition to existence of z transform of yk. We get a sufficient, it is not necessary, it is sufficient. If this holds, then z transform of yk exists. So if yk exponentially bounded, then z transform of yk exists. Now we will prove this. Assume that the sequence yk is exponentially bounded. That is, by using definition, then there is a positive m, c greater than 0, such that mod of yk less than or equal to m times of c to the power k for k greater than or equal to 0. So this condition is satisfied as sequence is exponentially bounded. Now when we say that this z transform exists, we know that if this summation is converges for mod z greater than r. If this proved, then we say that the z transform of yk exists. Now we have summation from k equal to 0 to infinity mod of yk upon zk. We have to show that it is convergent. Means what? It is less than or equal to some particular number. Okay. So k from 0 to infinity mod of yk upon z is to k less than or equal to summation k from 0 to infinity mod of yk upon z raised to k, mod of z raised to k. And as we have this one, mod yk less than or equal to m times c to the power k. So m is constant, can be taken outside. So this is less than or equal to m times summation from k equal to 0 to infinity c to the power k, mod of c to the power k upon, as c is greater than 1, it is positive, k is non-negative, it is also positive, whether you write mod c or c, both are same. So c to the power k upon z to the power k, that can be written as mod of c by z to the power k. Now, what about this c upon z? C is greater than 1, right? So when this is, convergent, if this denominator is greater than numerator, otherwise the value of this whole term increases and decreases. When this will be decreases? If this is less than 1. When this is less than 1 and its a power increases, we know that any term which is less than 1, its a power increases, will converge it. So when this will be less than 1? If z is greater than your c, that is mod of z is greater than mod of C. As C is a positive, so mod Z is greater than C. So this will be this will be converges to some number, whatever number is that L, for mod Z greater than C. So if I take mod Z greater than C, means capital R is your, there exists R such that for mod Z greater than R, this summation is converges to L. Therefore, this Z transform of YK exists. It follows that the Z transform of sequence YK exists. Similarly, we have the second simple result. If the sequence FK is exponentially bounded, then each solution of nth order difference equation is also exponentially bounded, and hence its Z transform exists. If it is a, if the each solution exponentially bounded, then we know that its Z transform exists from above result. Now what we have given and what we have to show, we have given that FK is exponentially bounded. What is FK here? Right hand side of that nth order difference equation. If FK is exponentially bounded, then we have to show that each solution of this nth order difference equation, is it nth order? Yes. YK, YK plus 1, YK plus 2 up to YK plus N. This is the nth order difference equation with constant coefficients. P1, P2 up to PN are here, constants we are given. So non-homogeneous nth order difference, each solution of this non-homogeneous nth order difference equation is exponentially bounded, and hence it's a Z transform exists. This it means what? This, which are the solutions of this non-homogeneous equation? Their Z transform exists. Consider the case n equal to 2. So we will prove for n equal to 2, and other part will be same, whatever the order is there. So for second order difference equation, we will show that, and parallelly we can say that it holds for nth order also. Assume that yk is solution of second order equation. So we consider this second order equation, and it's a solution, we consider yk. Yk plus 2 plus p1 yk plus 1 plus p2 yk equal to fk. And moreover, we have given fk is exponentially bounded. Right hand side we have given exponentially bounded. Since fk is exponentially bounded, there is a capital M greater than 0, c greater than 1, such that mod fk less than or equal to m times c to the power k for k greater than or equal to 0. This is by using definition. It is straightforward. Now, since yk is a solution of above second order difference equation, we have yk satisfies this equation, right? And therefore, taking mod of both sides, we get mod of here, mod of yk plus 2 mod of yk plus 2 equal to mod of fk. But we know that mod of yk plus 2 is less than or equal to, separate mod is there, mod of yk plus 2 plus p1 times mod of yk plus 1 plus p2 times mod of yk. Okay, and it should be like this. Okay, therefore, taking terms to right hand side, we obtain mod of yk plus 2 less than or equal to p1 times mod p1 times yk plus 1 plus mod p2 times yk plus yk plus m times c to the power k. Why m times c to the power k? Because this right hand side is less than or equal to m times c to the power k. So we obtain this equation number 1. Now let b is a maximum of this p1, p2, y0, y1, capital M, small c. We are considering b as maximum of all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms. Maximum of these 6 terms we have considered b. That means what? Here mod of p1 less than or equal to b, mod of p2 less than or equal to b, mod of y0 less than or equal to b, mod of y1 less than or equal to b, capital M less than or equal to b, small c less than or equal to b. Now we prove by induction that mod yk is always less than or equal to 3 to the power k minus 1 times b to the power k. Mod of yk is always less than or equal to, what we want to show, that 3 to the power k minus 1 b to the power k. This we will show by using induction method for k equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now for k equal to 1, so what induction method says? Show that the given result is true for k equal to 1. Suppose that the given result is true for some k equal to fixed number L, and then prove that it is also true for L plus 1. That is the induction method. So for first, for k equal to 1, for k equal to 1, we know that mod y1 is less than or equal to b, as b is the maximum for all these. Mod y1 less than or equal to b, that is mod y1 less than or equal to. How b can be written as b to the power 1, and how this coefficient 1 can be written in the power of 3, 3 to the power 1 minus 1. So by taking k equal to 1, I write 3 to the power k minus 1, that is 3 to the power 0 means 1, and b to the power k. So this is 2 is true for k equal to 1 as this holds. 2 is true for k equal to 1 as b, we have taken maximum of all these, therefore mod y1 is less than or equal to b. Okay. Thus 2 is true for k equal to 1. Now assume that k0 greater than or equal to 1, and that the inequality 2 is true for the value of k which is greater than or equal to 1 and strictly less than k0. Strictly less than k0. Okay. So what we are saying, suppose that this term, this equation is true, equation inequality number 2 is true for some value of k by proving it is true for k equal to 1. By proving it is true for k equal to 1, we suppose that it is true for some k, and which k? Which is less than k0. Letting k equal to k0 minus 1 into, because we now k0 minus 1 is strictly less than k0, and for that equation number 2 is true, we supposed it. Therefore, mod of y0 plus 1. Now, see here, letting k equal to k0 minus 1 into, what will happen here? Y k0 minus 1 less than or equal to 3 times k0 minus 1 into p to the power k0 minus 1, because 2 will be true for this k, because this k is less than k0. And we suppose that equation inequality 2 holds for all such values of k which are less than k0. So we have this one, yk0 minus 1 less than or equal to 3 times 3 to the power k0 minus 1 b to the power k0 minus 1 for this. Now here yk0 or yk0 equal to this one, yk0 less than or equal to 3 to the power k0 minus 1 into b to the power k0. Similarly, yk0 minus 1, if I take this one, then it will be less than or equal to 3 to the power k0 minus 2 into b to the power k0 minus 1. It is like that. Okay. So yk0 will be less than or equal to this, and yk0 will be less than or equal to this. So we are taking that this value satisfies for all values of k which are strictly less than k0. Thus, now we will go for k0 plus 1. So this is not 0, it is k0 plus 1. So mod of y k0 plus 1 will be less than or equal to, from this one, mod of y k0 plus 1 will be less than or equal to mod of p1 times y of k0 plus p2 times y of k0 minus 1 plus m times c to the power k0 minus 1. Here, in this equation, put k equal to, by putting k equal to k0 minus 1. So if I replace this by k0, k by k0 minus 1, you will get mod of y, because this holds for all values of k, no doubt, as yk is the solution of given equation. So yk0 plus 1 will be less than or equal to mod p1 y k plus mod p2 yk0 minus 1 plus m into c to the power k0 minus 1, because you are putting k by k0 minus 1. So you are getting this one. Now, as B is a maximum of that, mod P1 is less than or equal to B, right? And mod of YK0 less than or equal to 3 times 3 to the power K0 minus 1 B to the power K0 here, plus mod P2 is also less than or equal to B. Mod of YK0 minus 1, 3 to the power K0 minus 2, B to the power K0 minus 1, plus, right? M is also less than or equal to B because B is the maximum of all these things. B into B to the power K0 minus 1 because C less than or equal to B, therefore C to the power K0 minus 1 also less than or equal to B to the power K0 minus 1. Now, which is less than or equal to 3 to the power K0 minus 1, right? Into B to the power K0 plus 1, just multiplication there, plus 3 to the power K0 minus 2, B to the power K0 plus B to the power K0. Okay, it is like that. Now, how we can write? We have this term. Now, what we will do? This will as it is, right? This term will remain as it is, less than or equal to. So, it is equal to. What we have done? We have multiplied this term by B into 3 to the power K0. We have multiplied this term by B into 3, right? This term by B into 3. Obviously, 3 to the power K0 minus 2 into B to the power K0 will be less than or equal to 3 into 3 to the power K0 minus 2 into B into B to the power K0. Is it right or wrong? One minute. Where we are? Yes. So what I am saying here? This term 3 to the power K0 minus 2 into B to the power K0 less than or equal to 3 times B into 3 to the power K0 minus 2 into B to the power K0. Multiplying by 3 to the power B means what? This will be obviously less than or equal to this term. Similarly, for this B to the power K0, what we are taking? B to the power K0 less than or equal to 3 to the power K0 minus 1 into B times B to the power K0. Then you are multiplying to this term by this one, which is greater than 1. And therefore, this will be less than or equal to this term that we are doing. This is just adjustment is your, okay? So, we get 3 to the power K0 minus 1, B to the power K0 plus 1, 3 to the power K0 minus 1, B to the power K0 plus 1, 3 to the power K0 minus 1, B to the power K0 plus 1, and taking B to the power K0 plus 1 common, what you are getting here? We are getting 3 to the power K, 3 to the power K. All these we have seen. So, this is 3 times only. 3 times 3 to the power K0 minus 1 means 3 to the power 1 into 3 to the power K0 minus 1. This is 3 to the power K0 into B to the power K0 plus 1. So, what we have proved? Mod of Y K0 plus 1 less than or equal to 3 to the power K0 B to the power K0 plus 1. So, considering inequality 2 for K0, we proved that inequality also true for K0 plus 1. And therefore, by induction method, the inequality 2 is true. That is, so from that, how you can write? Inequality 2 is true. So, mod yk less than or equal to 3 to the power k minus 1 into b to the power k. From 2, can I write mod yk less than or equal to 3 to the power k into b to the power k? Because, again, 3 to the power k minus 1 into b to the power k less than or equal to 3 into 3 to the power k minus 1 into b to the power k, which is nothing but 3 to the power k b to the power k, which is nothing but 3b to the power k, which is there. That we have seen. for k equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So yk is exponentially bounded. This gives yk mod yk. So why we are taking yk is exponentially bounded? Because there exists a number c which is greater than 1, which is 3. So, and number m, what m is here? B to the power k is m. So this is a m c to the power k, and therefore mod yk is exponentially bounded. Why c? C is here 3, so I will consider c as 3, which is greater than 1, and I will consider b to the power k as some capital M. B to the power k as some capital M, and therefore, so there exists mod yk where this term is happens, or you can also consider this as m to the power k. So it is exponentially bounded for k equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So yk is exponentially bounded. Hence, and moreover, by theorem, if the sequence yk is exponentially bounded, then the z transform of yk exists, and here also the z transform of solutions of given equations exist. Z transform of solutions of given equation exist. Okay, that is the case. So this is about z transform and exponentially bounded. Small examples are there. Find the z transform of sequence yk equal to 1. So if y1 equal to 1, y2 equal to 1, y3 equal to 1 and so on. So what will be its z transform? Capital Y of z equal to z transform of 1 equal to summation from k equal to 0 to infinity. Yk is 1 here, 1 upon z to the power k. 1 upon z to the power k means what? 1 by z to the power k. This is nothing but 1 by z to the power k. And we know that summation k from 0 to infinity x to the power k is nothing but 1 plus x square plus up to plus 1. It is 1 upon 1 minus x. 1 upon 1 minus 1 by z. And that can be written as z upon z minus 1 for mod z greater than 1. Because this holds for mod x less than 1. That means this will hold for mod of 1 by z less than 1. This implies mod z greater than. That is the case. Okay. Find the z transform of sequence uk equal to a to the power k. Uk equal to a to the power k. So let u of z equal to z of a to the power k summation from k equal to 0 to infinity a to the power k upon z to the power k equal to summation k from 0 to infinity a by z to the power k, right? A by z to the power k, which is equal to 1 upon again 1 minus a by z. This holds for mod a by z greater than 1, that is mod z greater than a, which is equal to a calculation gives us z upon z minus a for mod z greater than a. By using these two examples, that z transform of 1 is z upon z minus 1 and z transform of a to the power k is z upon z minus a, we can obtain z transform of k also. Find the z transform of vk equal to k from k equal to 0 to infinity. So let v of z equal to z of k, which is k is here, summation from k equal to 0 to infinity k upon z to the power k, summation from k equal to 0 to infinity k plus 1 upon z to the power k plus 1. We can write k plus either k or k plus 1, whatever you may write. Okay, you are taking summation because their upper part is up to infinity there. Upper part is up to infinity. For k equal to 1, first term is 0. For k equal to 1, first term is 1 upon z. Here also for k equal to 0, first term is 1 upon k. Okay. So doesn't matter whatever you have written, this or this. If you take 1 by z outside, we get summation from k equal to 0 to infinity k plus 1 upon z to the power k. 1 z taken outside. K plus 1 upon z to the power. So 1 by z into k upon z to the power k and 1 upon z to the power k. Summation from k equal to 0 to infinity k upon z to the power k plus 1. K upon z to the power k, 1 upon z to the power k. K upon z to the power k, it is not k plus 1. K upon z to the power k plus 1 upon z to the power k. Right? Which is equal to 1 by z into, but what is summation from k equal to 0 to infinity k upon z to the power k? It is z of k. So 1 by z into z of k plus 1 by z into z of 1. So z of k is here right hand side and here it is also left hand side. So take zk common, take this to left hand side, 1 minus 1 by z, z of k equal to right hand side 1 by z into z of 1. But what is z of 1? Already we found z of 1 as z upon z minus 1. Z upon z minus 1. So we get zz cancel 1 upon z minus 1 for mod z greater than 1. And therefore z of k becomes, here what we get? Z minus 1 upon z. If I take that term to here, we get z minus 1 upon z. That can be written as z upon z minus 1. And this 1 upon z minus 1 as it is. That is total z upon z minus 1 whole square for mod z greater than 1. This is the z transform of k by using this example. Okay. As in the Laplace transform, the linearity property also satisfies in z transform. That is, if a and b are constants, then z transform of auk plus bvk equal to a times z transform uk plus b times z transform of vk. A times z transform of uk plus b times z transform of vk. For those z in common domain of, but one condition is there. The domain of u and domain of v must be common, must be same. That is called common. Okay. Now, proof is very simple. Z of a times uk plus b times vk is nothing but summation from k equal to 0 to infinity a uk plus b vk upon z raised to k. But now we know that summation is linear. Summation is linear operator. That is, summation of a plus b is same as summation of a plus summation of b. And summation constant times some function is same as constant time outside summation of that function. So a times summation of first term plus b times summation of second term. And this is your z of uk and this is our z of vk. So a times z of uk plus b times z of vk. From this linearity property also, we can find the z transform of sin ak. So as an example, find the z transform of sin ak from k equal to 0 to infinity. We get z transform of sin ak equal to z of e to the power I ak minus e to the power minus I ak divided by 2i, which is equal to 1 by 2i z transform of e to the power I ak minus 1 by 2i z transform of e to the power minus, because sin ak can be written as e to the power sin x. We know that sin x is your e to the power ix minus e to the power minus ix divided by 2i. This is your sin ix, sin x. So we use this e to the power ik minus e to the power minus ik divided by 2i. By using linearity, separate z transform can be taken. So 1 by 2i e to the power ik. It is z upon z minus e to the power I. What about this e to the power ik? So e to the power ia to the power k. It is like this. Right? By which you have taken this e to the power ik? See here. If vk is equal to k is this. A to the power k. What is the z transform of a to the power k? Z upon z minus a. So e to the power I a to the power k. What will be its z transform? Replace a by e to the power I a, which is constant term. So z upon z minus e to the power I. That's why we have taken that. Right? Z upon z minus e to the power I. Minus 1 by 2 I. Z upon z minus e to the power minus I. So, after taking calculations here, that is 2i is common in both, z minus e to the power ia into z minus e to the power minus ia, it's a product, and we get cross multiplication, z into z, z square, z into minus e to the power minus ia, minus z into e to the power minus ia, minus z into z, z square, and minus minus plus z into e to the power ia. So z square plus minus z square cancel, we get z minus z e to the power minus I plus z e to the power plus I. So z common we have taken e to the power I minus e to the power minus I, and division as it is 2i into product of these two. Product of these two means what? Z into z, z square z into minus e to the power minus I, minus e to the power I into z, and minus e to the power I into minus e to the power minus I, it becomes 1, minus minus plus e to the power 0 is 1. So this we get z into e to the power I minus e to the power minus I divided by 2i divided by z square minus z times e to the power I z square minus z times e to the power I a plus e to the power minus I a plus 1. Now this is your z into sin a. Z, this is what? Again, e to the power I a minus e to the power minus I a divided by 2a. 2i, that is sin a. So z sin a upon z square minus 2z. This is cos a. If I take divided by 2, it is cos a. So multiplying by 2 and dividing by 2. So 2z cos a plus 1. So z transform of sin a k is z sin a upon z square minus 2z cos a plus 1. In the same way, we can obtain z transform of cos a k also. Only we have to take this as expansion for, or this as a alternate method to write cos a k e to the power I a k plus e to the power minus I a k divided by 2, separate z transform, then simply calculation and replacing, we get z square minus z cos a divided by z square minus 2z cos a plus 1. This is parallel with sin a k. Okay, that is the case. There are some more examples which can be solved very easily. Some of them we will discuss here. Find the z transform of yk equal to 2 plus 3k. Now z transform of 2 plus 3k is z transform of 2 plus z transform of 3k. That can be written as 2 times z transform of 1 plus 3 times z transform of k. So z transform of 1 is z upon z minus 1 plus 3 times z transform of k is k upon z upon z minus 1 whole square for mod z greater than 1. So this becomes 2z upon z minus 1 plus 3z upon z minus 1 whole square. The LCM of this is z minus 1 whole square, and by taking cross multiplication we will obtain this term 2z square minus 2z plus 3z, which is equal to 2z square plus z upon z minus 1 whole square. That is z into z plus 1 upon z minus 1 whole square. This is a simple calculation by taking what? How this obtain? Z minus 1 whole square is LCM. So multiplying both sides by z minus 1 whole square, we get 2z into z minus 1 plus 3z. Now 2z into z minus 1 is 2z square minus 2z and plus 3z as it is. Okay. Similarly, we can find the z transform of 3 to the power k into cos 2k. 3 to the power k into cos 2k. So this becomes z transform of 3 to the power k cos 2k, z of 3 to the power k cos 2k is this one, right? E to the power 2ik plus e to the power minus 2ik divided by 2, taking separate, that is 1 by 2 z transform of 3 into e to the power 2ik, because both are 3 to the power k, e to the power 2i to the power k, so 3 into e to the power 2i to the power k plus z transform of 3 into e to the power minus 2i to the power k. Now we know that z transform of a to the power k, so we consider this as a, right? And by using that, z upon z minus 3 e to the power 2i plus z upon z minus 3 e to the power minus 2i. Again, take multiplication of these two in the denominator, take cross multiplication in the numerator and solve it. We obtain this term, z into z minus 3 cos 2i, z minus 3 cos 2. Not 2i, right? Because I is there, e to the power I2 plus e to the power minus I2. It is cos 2 upon 2. So multiplying by 2, you will get 6 here. So it is not 2i, it is just z square minus 6 cos z plus 9. In this way, you can find the solution of some more examples there and you can solve it. You go for all these examples try at yourself. Okay, we will stop here for today's lecture.